Good morning, Valley Victory kids. It's Sunday morning and it's time to worship the Lord. Let's give God all of our attention and listen to what He has to say. So today's topic is an amazing topic, one of my favorite topics, that we must live to please God. That's right, we must live to please God. As a Christian, now we get to live for something greater than ourselves. Now we get to live for something bigger than ourselves, something better than ourselves, and that is not for ourselves, but for God. And to live to please God, that is our new purpose, and that is a great purpose to live for. But my question for you this morning is this: but why must we live to please God? We have been taught that by the teachers, by the pastors. But have we really thought about why we need to live to please God? Well, to get to the bottom of the answer, we must go back, all the way back to Genesis chapter 1. So what happens in the very beginning? In the very, very beginning in Genesis chapter 1, we all know that God had created the heavens and the earth. That's right. In His great power, in His great goodness, God has created all things in 6 days. God has created the light, the sun, moon, and the stars, the earth, the plantations, all the animals, and everything in it. Everything that you can imagine of this world, God has created it. And on the 6th day, God has created man. And instead of speaking into existence, God has formed man in His image, in His likeness. And God breathed out His spirit into his body, and the man became alive and became a living being. But let me pause and ask you this. Why do you think God did that? So our question that we want to answer is why? Why did God create all of that? And why must we live to please God? What's the connection? The connection is this: that God has created all things because, according to the Bible, that gave God great pleasure. The creation gave God great pleasure. So what do you say when you are pleased? So for example, let's say you all go to your favorite restaurant and you're so hungry and you eat your favorite meal and that was so delicious. What do you say at the end after having that wonderful meal? You say, that was very good. That was very good. That's exactly what God said. Genesis chapter 1, verse 31, the very last verse says, after God has created everything, this is what God said. Genesis 1, 31 says, and God saw everything that He had made, and behold, it was very good. Very good. And there was evening and there was morning the 6th day. So if God had a cell phone, right, He would use an emoji, a thumbs up emoji. Not just one, because it wasn't just good, but it was very good. It would have been a double thumbs up emoji. That's right. So God was very, very pleased. That gave Him great pleasure. And that is why God has created you and me, including the rest of the world. But were we able to continue to live for that purpose? No. Unfortunately, we can no longer do that because of our sin. Sin broke our relationship with God, and we are now no longer able to live to please God. But God, in His great mercy and His grace, God had made a way for us to live for His pleasure once again, and that is through Jesus Christ. He became the bridge that bridged us and God, and we are now able to continue to live to please God. But my final question for all of us is this: now that we understand why we need to, because that was our original purpose of creation, how can we continue to live to please God? So our final question is how? Well, we can continue to please God not on our own strength, but according to Philippians chapter 2, the Bible gives us a secret on how we can live for God's good pleasure. This is what Paul said in Philippians chapter 2, verse 13, which is also our today's memory verse. It says, "For it is God who works in you, both to will and to work for His good pleasure." Isn't that awesome? God says, "Now I want you to live for my pleasure," but God doesn't leave us alone for us to do that, for us to have a stronger willpower, or for us to have a better plan so that we can continue to live for God, to please God. No, no, no. The Bible tells us that we are able to live to please God because God, who is in us, is working in us, and He is giving us the ability to have a will and to do and to work for His good pleasure. So all we have to do is trust in God more, follow God more, and love God more. Let's all bow our heads and pray. Father God, we thank You for this wonderful truth. Thank You that You have created us because it brings You great pleasure. And I pray that we will continue to do so by trusting in God who works in us in the form of the Holy Spirit, allowing us to will and to work for the good pleasure. And Father, O Lord, help us to live for Your glory and not for ourselves, for it is the perfect thing. It is the best thing that is for You, and that is the best thing for us. Help us to trust in You and live for Your pleasure. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.